Hello friends, welcome to a new lecture. Now in this lecture I would like to discuss about the dynamic hip screw. So I have a couple of pictures which show dynamic hip screw and how does it use. So if you see, this is the dynamic hip screw. If you see this dynamic hip screw, if you wanted to see the complete picture, it looks like this. The dynamic hip screw looks like this. So in the dynamic hip screw, it has three parts. This is called as barrel plate. This is the barrel plate, whereas this is the locking screw. This is the cannulated hip screw. So this is the barrel plate. This is the locking screw. This is the cannulated, this is the locking screw. This is the cannulated hip screw. Okay. This is called cannulated because there is a hollow space in between and this locking screw goes into this hollow space. So how is this? First, let me tell you how this dynamic hip screw fits. So this is the barrel plate. This pen, the one which I drew with pen, this is the barrel plate. So to this barrel plate, you will first attach this cannulated screw from behind, from below. Okay. You will attach this cannulated screw from below. Okay. This is the cannulated hip screw. You see, if you see, there is a canal in between. There is a space in between. There is a hollow space in between. In the middle, inside in the middle, there is hollow space. So that is the reason why it is called as a cannulated hip screw. This cannulated hip screw, it is fit into this barrel plate here. Now, this locking screw which is there, this is put from the barrel plate here. This locking screw goes over here from the barrel plate. It is fixed so that this locking screw enters the cannulated, enters the canal of the cannulated hip screw and it is fixed there. So, this is about the dynamic hip screw. How does it fit? So, what is the use of this dynamic hip screw? It is used for intertrochanteric fractures. Okay. Now, what are the uses of this dynamic hip screw? So this dynamic hip screw helps in firm fixation. That is when locking screw locks the hip screw. See, if you see this locking screw which is there, that is this locking screw, it will lock the cannulated hip screw. It goes into the canal of the hip screw and it locks here by with the help of threads. So when that is fixed, then the barrel plate which is there, that gets tightened. So it tightly attaches to the bone. That is firm fixation. It helps in firm fixation. And the second one is compression. Compression is brought when the patient starts bearing weight and screw begins to slide. This is slide in the barrel plate. This is slide in the barrel plate. First, if you see, when the person starts walking, then the screw which is there, this will slide over the barrel plate and thus it causes compression. So it has both firm fixation and also compression effect. So if you see, this is the dynamic hip screw. I will see it's fitting to the bone. So it fits something like this. First you put a barrel plate and then you will put this cannulated hip screw, and over this cannulated hip screw and barrel plate, you will put the fixing screw like this. Okay. It goes into the cannulated hip screw and it locks over there. Okay. So this is about the dynamic hip screw. So thank you guys for watching my lecture. This is about dynamic hip screw and barrel plate. In the next class, we will learn about javelin pits. So thank you for watching my lecture.